We are going to look at bubble sort algorithm today. And bubble sort is one of the simplest algorithms for arranging numbers in order of magnitude. It could be in ascending or in descending order. Let me just explain on the board. When we talk about sorting, sorting actually means an arrangement. And like I said earlier, the sorting could be of your numbers or your figures, could be in ascending or descending. If it is in ascending, it will look like something like a triangle like this. You have the minimum, the least number here, and then you have the maximum at this point. And then this we call ascending. This is in ascending order. Order of magnitude, or it could be in descending order of magnitude, and it will look something like this. This is the maximum number, and while this is the minimum. So we have this is called this is in descending order of magnitude, and then when we say bubble. And it looks like when somebody is chewing a gum, and then if I have somebody's face like this, and then he's chewing a gum, and then he blows it out. Sometimes it looks like this. That's why they call it, that's why it derives its name, bubble sort, because it grows from the least to the largest value. Of course, this is in ascending order of magnitude, just like this. Of course, this can also be used to reverse it in a descending order of magnitude. Now, assuming we have, to illustrate this and the method, assuming we have some values, maybe in an array, we have some values, say, B1, B2, B3 up to Bn, and we want to arrange them in maybe in ascending order of magnitude. How do we do this? The way we achieve this, the way the algorithm works, is to take these first two and then compare them. When you compare these two, you pick the one that is bigger. Assuming B2 is the larger of the figure, then this one will now be B2, and then this one becomes B1, B3, then up to Bn. You will continue with this arrangement, because the next time you will do this, you will also compare this B1 and B3. And then if, for example, B3 is bigger than B2, then the next arrangement will be B2, B3, for example, B1, and then up to Bn. And it will continue like that. That algorithm will recursively be called to arrange these values. When the biggest values comes to the end, the biggest value for the first time comes to the end, that will have been done, that comparison will have been done n minus one time before you achieve that. That is in the case of the, in the worst case scenario. The biggest will come when the first time you go through and you move the largest value to the top. Then you will do that. There will be n minus at least, or at most, n minus one comparison to do that. And when you are able to do that, after you have run through and the largest, and the value, the largest value, the first largest value comes up while the others are unsorted. That is called the first pass. When you have done that, this is called the first pass. And we are going to take an example. And then once the largest value is already there, at the end we neglect it. The next time we don't consider the largest value, since already there, we don't arrange that again. It's not part of the arrangement. Then you take the ones that are not sorted, and then you start the algorithm again, and then you start to compare until the whole value is arranged. So you can have second pass, because the pass is actually the steps you take to push the maximum at the end. That is what you mean by a pass. So you can do the first pass, and then of course the other value, this one will be bn minus 1. So these values to bn minus 1 is also unsorted. So that algorithm will continue again until you pick the largest of these, and then you put it next to the last largest value, and so on. And then when you do the second one, it's like you have the at most n minus 2 comparison that you have to make to get that, and so on and so forth. So as you go on, you see that the second pass, and then you go on until you get to n minus until you get to the end where these values will go on. You will even get to 1. That is when the arrangement will be complete. Now I want us to take a simple example with figures so that we will drive home this method for us to actually understand what we have done. Again, let me just explain that when you do this, this is n minus 1, as we have said. Now, if you want to do this, you interchange them. And then to interchange this, because when you compare this, if, for example, you say, like this, if we take this one, and we say, if B1 is greater than B2, of course, it means that B1 is greater than B2. And then we interchange them. And the way we interchange is something like this. Assuming we have 3 locations, and I call this one temp. And I have a location in memory storing, maybe this is storing B1, this one is storing B2, this one contains B2. Now, if I want to put B2 in B1, what do I do? One thing I can do is to put this one here. I put this one temporary, which is containing nothing. I can put my B1 here. And then I can write this one here to override this one. So this one becomes B2. Then this one, I can now write this here. So this one now becomes B1. That is how this change can be achieved. And therefore, simple pseudo code will be that if this is D, then temp is equals to temp is equals to B1, and then this one is equals to, this is our B1, this was our earlier B1, and this is B2, and therefore, if this one is containing this, then in the place of B1, we can put B2. So we can now say B1 is equals to B2, and then that means now here, B2 is now equals to temp. So we can say B2 is equals to temp. So we can see that this pseudo code will interchange these values. And so this point can be called recursively at any point we want to do an interchange. So now we will take a simple example. Let me take an example that will give us a worst case scenario. Assuming I have a value that is arranged in ascending order. Say I have 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is highly disorganized because this one is at the end and then we want to arrange. So what we said earlier is that when we take our first pass, now this is the original value. Now if we want to change, we compare this, we compare 5 and 4. And then because 5 is bigger than 4, so this one will be 4, 5, then we write it again, 2, 1. And then the next one is that we compare this and this. So we have 4, 3, 5, 2, 1. Then the next one is to compare 5 and 2. We have 4, 3, 2, 5, 1. And then the next one is to compare these last two. We have 4, 3, 2, 1, 5. And then you can see, and that's what I said earlier, that this one, it will take at most n minus 1. At most n minus 1. And you can see that our n here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 comparisons. So if you say 5 minus 1, that is 4. So in a sense, this is 4. We have 4 comparisons. Then the next one, we will start with this as our raw data. Like I said earlier, when you bubble the largest value to the top, we don't concern ourselves with this 5 again. We are left 4, 3, 2. And so what we now do, we also do a comparison. We compare this and this. This is 3, 4, 2, 1. We leave our 5 there. And then we also compare this. This is 3, 2, 4, 1, 5. And then we compare this and this. This is 3, 2, 1, 4, 5. So we can see that these two have been bubbled to their respective places. And this one is also n minus 2. Because this is 5. 5 minus 2 is 3. So it took 3 comparisons to get this done. Then similarly, we will now similarly do the same for the next value to be bubbled, which is 3. So we compare 3 and 2. So it will be 2, 3, 1, 4, 5. Then the next one is to compare 3 and 1. So it will be 2, 2, 1, 3, 4, 5. So you can see that these 3 is already arranged. They are bubbled into their rightful place. Therefore, this one is how many? 2. So it's the same thing as n minus 3. Because our n is 5, and 5 minus 3 is 2. So the last one will be, we will now take this one, and then we compare this and this, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that is the last arrangement. And of course, this one is n minus 4, which is 1, because 5 minus 1 is 4. So essentially, you can see that this one is 1, 2, 3, 4. So now we will be talking about the complexity of this algorithm. Essentially, here we will be talking about the number of comparisons that took place, the amount of work that the system will have to do to get this arranged. And how do we do it? Now, one of the ways that this can be done is to also take the case of summation. Now, if you have 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n, we can sum it. If I call this one as Sn, is this. Of course, I can reverse this. So let me add this one. If I say n minus 1 plus n plus n, this one here will be n minus 2, and so on. Now I can come back here and I can say I can rewrite this Sn. And say this Sn is the same thing as n plus n minus 1. The next one will have n minus 2 plus, and so on, 2 plus 1. This arrangement is the same thing as this. If we revert it, if we take it, this one is in ascending, as only we convert it and we add them. So if I add these two together, this is going to be 2Sn, and this is equals to, if I add this and this, this is n plus 1. If I add this and this, it's the same thing as n plus 1, because it's going to be n minus 1 plus 2, which is n plus 1. If I add this, n minus 2 plus 3 is the same thing as n plus 1. So we can have it like that. And then the thing can continue up to n plus 1 plus n plus 1. Now, this is 2Sn. Of course, we know that this one happened n times. This is n times. So I can simply say this is n into n plus 1. I can use that. Therefore, 2Sn is equal to this. So Sn is equal to, by induction, is equal to n into n plus 1 all over 2. Now, this one, our f of n for this, from this, our f of n for this comparison is going to be our f of n, because usually we represent our complexity rather by c of n, maybe something like this. Sometimes we write c of n, or some choose to write f of n. So in this case, we can stick to c of n, since we are talking about complexity. So c of n is equal to, from here, is the same thing as, is equal to 1 plus 2 plus up to n minus 1, because this one is n minus 1. That's where it terminates. So now, in this place, if I want to use this, I can change this one to be my n. Anywhere I have n, because in this case, this is my n, n minus 1. Actually, it's n minus 1. But for this, I can take it as my, assuming this one is m, I can now say my m is equal to n minus 1. So in this case, I will take this as my n. So in the place of n, I can substitute this. So my c of n, since I know that if I'm adding to n, it will be like this. So this one will be, where does n? I say n minus 1, and I say, where I have n here, I say n minus 1, then plus 1, because this one, n plus 1. So, but this one is n, so this is plus 1. Now, all over 2. So, this one is the same thing as n, because this one plus this, this one minus 1 plus 1 will cancel out, so this is n into n minus 1 all over 2. So my c on n for this, the c of n for this algorithm is equal to n into n minus 1 divided by 2. That is the c of n, that is the complexity for bubble sort. And of course, approximately, if you are looking at the big O, this is because essentially this is going to be n, n square minus n all over 2, which is abruptly n square, O n square. So that is the complexity, and that is the explanation on bubble sort. I hope we have gotten that which I have said. Thank you very much.